Homey Pro just got a big upgrade. The SmartWings app has officially landed in the Homey App Store. This means SmartWings shades and blinds can now integrate directly with Homey Pro. I had requested that Homey add the SmartWings shades app shortly after I installed my Homey Pro hub. It took a little time, but here we are. The official SmartWings app is live. Quick tip, if you ever want a brand added to Homey, use the Request a Brand link. It's how I got the SmartThings app added to the store. It's worth mentioning that Homey apps are available at no cost to you. There is a link to donate to community developers, which is a good way to reward them for their work. With the SmartThings app installed on my Homey Hub, I connected and tested my SmartWings outdoor Zigbee roller shades, and I created an advanced flow to automate them. In today's episode, I'll take you through the setup of that flow, which controls my shades based on weather conditions and whether or not we're at home. Before we review my setup, let me explain that SmartWings has earned a permanent spot in my smart home. I've installed a total of 7 SmartWings window coverings in my home to date. These include 4 Zigbee roller blinds and 3 Matter cellular shades. My first SmartWings shade installation was on the window above my kitchen sink. Since our window faces west, it gets a lot of late afternoon sun. That shade has been running reliably for over 3 years. Solid performance and 0 issues. SmartWings makes all kinds of custom window coverings: roller, zebra, Venetian, woven wood, plus a collection of outdoor shades. Their motors are whisper quiet, and you can power them by a rechargeable battery with a solar panel or hardwire them. If you're interested, I'll drop an affiliate link in the description. It helps the channel and it doesn't cost you extra. Homey's new SmartWings app supports Matter, Zigbee, and Z-Wave motors. When I migrated my outdoor Zigbee roller shades over from SmartThings, pairing to Homey was fast and painless. Once connected, I rebuilt my former SmartThings shade automation in a Homey Advanced flow, and it's actually an improvement. In SmartThings, I needed to create additional automations in Sharp Tools in order to make them work properly. However, in Homey, the automation is conveniently streamlined in one advanced flow. Here's how the flow works. Actions are triggered by the sun's position using the Sun Events app. I also use the Heimdall app to check if anyone's at home. If not, no need to drop the shades. Next, it pulls data from the Open Weather app. The flow examines temperature, wind, precipitation, and even the percentage of cloud cover. If it's calm and clear, the shades lower at 1 hour before golden hour begins. Golden hour is the period about 1 hour before sunset, when the sunlight is softer and has a warm glow. If weather factors are unfavorable, the shades remain up. And if weather conditions worsen while the shades are down, the shades are also raised up, and I get an instant notification. Pretty slick, right? If you would like to replicate this flow, you need to install the Open Weather app and request a free Open Weather API key. I've linked a former YouTube tutorial that walks you through the easy process of grabbing that API key. In the reference video, I explained how to install the API key in the Sharp Tools app, but the process is the same in Homey. You just need to paste the key into the Open Weather's app settings, and the app will set your location and you'll be good to go. All right, let me jump over to my PC and I'll walk you through exactly how this flow looks in Homey. I'm still tweaking my setup, adding some forecast checks and even echo announcements that confirm why the shades were adjusted. So you can expect some fine tuning down the road. So let's go ahead and get into the flow and I'll show you how it works. Let's jump right in here. All right, this is the flow. And by the way, I've got a live view of our Reolink outdoor camera. And these are the shades. They're shade 1 and shade 2, which you really can't see there on the porch face there. So we'll go through an explanation of the flow here. So I have several cards I'm using. I have event cards. They're these red cards here. And they give me the sun's position. So I use this card up here to determine when golden hour starts, and I offset that by minus 60, so roughly 2 hours before sunset, that's when that card is triggered. This is a sunset event, sun events card, and that's triggered, of course, at sunset. So when the golden hour starts, 60 minutes before the golden hour, the shades are put down, and By the way, our porch is facing to the west, and the sun is right in your face. So it's necessary when the sun gets low in the horizon, about 2 hours before sunset, that those shades come down so that you can enjoy the outdoors. And then they're, of course, raised after the sun sets by these routines. So I have those sun event cards. All these cards here are SmartWings cards. They determine the state of the blind, and then they change the state of the blind. Then I have a Heimdall card here that determines whether we're home or not. If we're home, the house is always disarmed, so that's how it can tell by that state. And in addition to that, all of these orange cards, including this card over here, are the open weather cards. So those are the ones from the open weather app, and they determine the state of the weather. I'll go through these more carefully up next, but let's finish what cards I have. I have push notification cards over here, and I also have a couple of Alexa cards here. So let's go through this. When it's 60 minutes before the start of golden hour, this card would be triggered. Then it would go here and test whether or not we are at home. Next, it checks the temperature to see if it's a warm day, otherwise we wouldn't be out on the porch. Then it checks if wind speed is greater than 15 miles per hour. If it is, it leaves the shades up, it doesn't close them. And then finally it checks to see if it's cloudy out. So if it's overcast, the shades obviously don't need to come down. But if it's less than 85% cloudiness, I have the shades come down. So let's go ahead and execute that and see how it works. So we'll select test from here. So it goes through, checks we're home. It suggests that the wind speed is greater than 15 miles per hour. So it went to this and checked to see if the blinds are down. They're not, so there's no reason to raise them. So if we go here and look at the blinds, they are not down. And that's because you can see it's fairly windy outside. We're going to go ahead and force the blinds to close. We're going to assume that it's less than 15 miles per hour. So let's go back to the flow, and I'm just going to change this variable, and we're going to make this 20. Now, normally I wouldn't put the blinds down when it's greater than 15, and you'll see why in just a minute. So we're going to go and exit that. I'll save that change. Let's execute this command a second time. And it's going to check wind speed here. It's going to find that it is less than 20 miles an hour, and it's not cloudy, so it should be setting the blinds down at this point. And there you see them coming down. And you will see, even though these blinds have cable guides on them, they tend to billow quite a bit when the wind's greater than 15 miles an hour. Not sure exactly where it is. We can check it in just a minute. But the shades are down all the way, and we can go back to our flow, and we'll exit from that test, and let's raise those blinds back up. So let's assume it's sunset. It finds the blinds down, so it's going to set them back up again. Let's check. And as you can see, the blinds are raising back up. Now, as those come back up, let's go back in. I'm going to let that test finish. Let's see where they're at here. All right, they're almost up. And I'm going to go into device settings here. We can exit that now. This is the open weather tile, and just show you all the conditions that are available in this tile. So we have date and time, we have the condition of the sky, we have different weather temperatures based on time, we have humidity, we have the level of cloudiness, which is 0% today, we have wind direction, so it's coming, looks like from the south. And it's at 19 kilometers per hour. This says kilometers per hour, but actually it's miles per hour I'm not sure why it's reporting as kilometers. Then also we have precipitation, snow, sunrise, sunset times, whether it's clear or what the condition of the sky is. So a lot of different elements available within that tile. So let's go back to our flow here. I've got a shortcut on the main screen. Let's look at this last piece of the flow. This checks weather. The open weather tile checks weather every 5 minutes. So if there's a change and the blinds were down and then the wind suddenly kicks up, if you remember, this wind was 19 miles an hour. So it should trigger this to continue. These other ones, rainy, thunderstorm, extreme weather, excessive cloudiness, those are not true. So let's test it from here. So everyone is false except for the wind speed. The wind speed is greater than 15 miles per hour. So it checks to see if the blinds are down. They're not. So there's no need to set them up. Now, what would happen in all of these cases, I'll exit out of here. On the positioning of the blinds down, I have a push notification come to my phone that tells me that the blinds are down. When they go up, I also have a separate push notification for that. And then if they're closed prematurely because of inclement weather, I have a notice come to my phone, plus I have an echo announcement that tells me that the shades have been positioned up, and it gives me the specific reason, the specific weather condition that caused the shades to position up. So it's a pretty nice flow. It works pretty well. And I'm still doing some tweaking on it. I may make some changes, but I will make this available if somebody would like to have a copy of it.
Bottom line, SmartWings now has official Homey support. And if you're looking for seamless smart shade control, this combo is hard to beat. Drop a comment with the automations you'd create. I'd love to hear your ideas. And of course, hit like, subscribe, and check out my other Homey automation guides. We'll see you in the next video.